Hello there, Matt with LINBIT here. In the following video, I'm going to demonstrate LINBIT's LINSTOR add-on for the OpenNebula cloud platform. LINSTOR is at the center of LINBIT's SDS solutions. It transparently provides DRB-replicated block storage to OpenNebula without the need for specialty hardware or proprietary software. LINSTOR integrates seamlessly into OpenNebula, providing your cluster with the rich set of features and flexibility we've come to expect from modern Linux storage systems like LVM or ZFS, all with the added durability and availability provided by DRBD's replication. I'll quickly describe the cluster I'll be demonstrating and then show the LINSTOR add-on in action. So on the LINSTOR side of things, you can see we have a four-node cluster with two storage pools defined to demonstrate storage tiering. One storage pool is comprised of directly attached slow but dense spinning media, which is thickly provisioned by LINSTOR via LVM. And the other storage pool is comprised of directly attached and much more performant SSD drives, which will be thinly provisioned by LINSTOR via LVM. Both span all four nodes in this case, but that's not a requirement. Over on the OpenNebula side, we already have the LINSTOR driver installed, and I've configured our SSD thin storage pool as a data store for OpenNebula. And that would be this LINSTOR SSD data store. You can see some of the properties we set when defining our LINSTOR backed data stores, the most important being the bridge list, LINSTOR auto place, and the LINSTOR storage pool. Those properties specify which nodes the data store is present on, all four nodes in this cluster, how many replicas of each volume created in the data store should we have, and the name of the LINSTOR storage pool to carve our volumes out of. We only have two images in OpenNebula at this point, one being an OS volume for a KDE Neon installation I've prepared, and the other being the install media I used to create the prior. Both of these were created in LINSTOR SSD data store, so these images should be the only images we see when we jump to the command line and look at the LINSTOR resources. And there we see the two images. Both have two physical copies of the data. And you can also see that OpenNebula 16 is currently in a diskless state, which means there's no physical copy of that volume on KitFox. But it's using DRBD's diskless protocol to access the data from one of the nodes that does have a replica. We don't have any VMs yet in OpenNebula, so let's make some. I've prepared a template, and we can use that to deploy instances of the KDE Neon image I pointed out earlier. Let's make 10 of them and take a look at things from both the OpenNebula and LINSTOR perspective. Looks good. And we'll give that a second to complete. Let's refresh. Okay. And there we see we have all of our 10 VMs running in OpenNebula. So let's jump over to LINSTOR and see what the resource list looks like now. All right, and there we see plenty of new resources. I can tell from this perspective that our VMs are running all over our cluster. Let's jump back to OpenNebula and take a closer look at where those are. Okay, we can see pretty even distribution. From here, I'll show you that live migration is possible for OpenNebula instances stored on LINSTOR-backed data stores. But let's quick open something up on a desktop of one of our VMs. We'll pick 100 here. And that'll just prove that we're doing the migration live and not restarting the instances. Okay, and I'll jump back to our list. Let's select all our VMs. And I'll tell them to live migrate over to SwiftFox. And then I'll quickly jump to the terminal so we can see the resources move and become primary on the target by looking at Derby Top. Okay, and all our resources have become primary on SwiftFox. So let's jump back to the desktop of our VM100 and see that we still have that text file just to prove that we live migrated and didn't restart. And these are okay. Some of the VMs were already on SwiftFox, so those are just warnings. There's a VM100. And there's our text file. All right. If you'd like to know more about the software demonstrated in this video, head on over to linbit.com and reach out to us. But that's all for now. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe.